Nice to see you guys and welcome back to chapter 7 and hence the last chapter of the Great Plateau portion of my Breath of the Wild Any% No Amiibo Speedrun tutorial series. After this very short but tricky section, you guys will be ready to run Great Plateau Any%, which I will upload a fully commentated run of in the next days to show you the minor differences between that and completing the plateau in a full speedrun. For now, let's dive into the paraglider segment in which we move from the bomb shrine to the Temple of Time to get the paraglider while completing some tasks along the way. Let's do it! No surprises here. When the last monk cutscene plays, we want to wait until the text fully dissolves before skipping the last cutscene for faster loads to then meet the old man again after leaving the bomb shrine. For this conversation, you don't have to make dialogue choices, so just spam the B button to mash through the text until the man disappears to meet you at the Temple of Time. After you gain control of Link again, immediately draw a bomb and throw it without moving Link at all. Once the bomb is far enough away from you, you can activate it to blow up the rubble blocking the way. You get to make a choice here depending on your arrow count. If you have more than 2 arrows, which are mandatory to get to Hyrule Castle, you can shoot the Decayed Guardian here to wake him up, skipping the cutscene that usually plays, as described in Chapter 6. If you only have 2 arrows, switch to the square bomb after blowing up the rubble and use that to wake up the Guardian. This is slightly slower but mandatory if you need to save those arrows. As soon as the Guardian wakes up, you want to sprint and whistle sprint this way to avoid being lasered by him. I personally jump over the bricks here to preserve my momentum and switch my module to stasis midair, which we will need later. As we get closer to the top of the hill and leave the Guardian's range, stop whistle sprinting and change to throw sprinting instead to refill your stamina, as we now need to collect a mighty beetle from this forest area, which we will use in Hyrule Castle later to cook an attack up portion to speed up the boss fights. The position of this beetle is random and out of our control, but if you're lucky, he will be on the tree straight ahead. If this is the case, you can run until you reach this muddy ground texture. From here, jump and go into a crouching position once you land. 2 crouch hops will allow you to catch him. If you scare the beetle away, somewhere on these trees you should be able to find another one, so keep an eye out. You do need it for the no amiibo completion of the run. Now I will show you some other common spots where the beetle could be and how to catch them accordingly. After you caught the beetle, we want to perform another stasis launch on a tree that reaches the roof of the Temple of Time. And even though this might not seem like the most important strat to go for, and is actually, in my opinion, one of the hardest and most annoying ones too, it's actually really important in a full Any% run. The reason for this is the red Bokoblin in front of the Temple of Time. After we get the paraglider, our plan is to manipulate him into a spot where we can BTB of him to fly all the way to Hyrule Castle. If you miss this tree launch and are forced to walk up to the Temple of Time, his starting position can change, causing your first attempt at the Hyrule Castle BTB to automatically fail. With this tree launch, we will always be able to find him in the expected spot. In a Great Plateau 80% run, you won't need the beetle at all, since your run ends when you get the paraglider, so starting out you can easily skip this very hard strat and just run to the Temple of Time climbing up the ladder. But now let's get into how to actually perform this strat. I will explain it using the tree the beetle is on optimally, but will also show you other trees you can use if the beetle is in a different spot. After catching the beetle, hit the tree once with your axe, which will allow you to chop it using less stamina in the next step. You can cancel the first hit animation with a jump to be a little bit faster. Now, we need to spin attack into a spin cancel to chop down the tree. A normal hit will not allow you to stasis the tree in time. after the spin attack hits the tree, immediately cancel the spin, like explained in the first chapter, and then use stasis on the tree as soon as it is in about this position. Now we need to act fast, turn around and start spin attacking the tree to charge the stasis arrow until red. A way to assure double hits is moving towards the tree and to the right. It is very easy to run out of stamina before you charge the tree to red, essentially making this entire strat useless. Any stasis strength below red has almost no chance to reach the Temple of Time's roof, so practicing this is very important. A specific scenario here is when an acorn falls down from the tree after you chopped it. Make sure to pick up this acorn, as Link likes focusing his spin attack's attention on it instead of the actual tree. After the arrow is red, we need to redirect the angle of the launch. To do that, you can crouch down and then fire an arrow in a steep angle to make the arrow aim above the roof of the Temple of Time. The closer you can aim your tree towards the cutscene trigger, the better, obviously. Once the tree is fully charged and lined up, we need to get Link to grab onto it, which is the most infuriating part. The most consistent way for me to do it is run to the side of the tree with a little distance and then jump towards it with forwards momentum. If you can't get onto the tree in time, which will sadly happen a lot when you start out, make sure to at least get your arrow back so you can either try again or simply run to the Temple of Time, risking the chance of the Bokoblin changing position. But if you do manage to make Link hug the tree, you can just collect the arrow mid-flight. Let go of the tree by pressing B and then run towards the cutscene trigger. Avoid whistling at all costs here, as this will alert the Bokoblin early, messing up his positioning for the upcoming BTB to Hyrule Castle. You just gotta make sure to dodge the holes in the Temple of Time's roof when landing. If you do happen to fall into these, you can save yourself by performing a fall damage cancel and then just climb up the ladder. As you reach the cutscene trigger, you need to skip 3 consecutive cutscenes and then mesh through a bit of dialogue before you obtain the paraglider from the king himself. Most of us split on audio cue here, using the 4th note of the fanfare that plays when you get the glider. This marks the end of the Great Plateau and optimally a little more than half of the full run. If you made it this far, you can be very proud of you. Now is the time to prepare yourself to encounter Ganon by speedrunning this part of the game known as Great Plateau Anypercent. I challenge you to beat this section in less than 20 minutes consistently before you move on to take on to the extremely dangerous Hyrule Castle, Blights, and Calamity Ganon himself. In a few days, as mentioned, I am uploading a fully commentated Great Plateau Anypercent run, pointing out all the very minor differences between an Anypercent run's plateau section and if you just run it on its own, so make sure to subscribe for that one. For more questions, the Breath of the Wild speedrunning server is linked in the description as always, and so is my Twitch channel where I answer questions and do full runs of this game almost daily, so just come by and say hi. I'll be working very hard on the next video about the Hyrule Castle segment, which will cover a huge amount of information. I expect it to be over 30 minutes long, so it will take a while until it is finished. I'm also traveling to the United States to visit Summer Games Done Quick 2019 and commentate Volhaik Song's Breath of the Wild Anypercent run there. Make sure to catch it if you can. So the video will probably come out at the start of July, I wanna say, and I will finish the series from there. I am gonna make sure this series is done by the mid of July, so you can do the entire run. Now, get those low plateau times, keep practicing, and see you soon.